Hello everyone, myself Ariman Modi, and I'm here on behalf of ACES for a very informative session on open source. Here we would discuss some insights of open source and help you to put your first hands on it. So be connected and let's start.
So we would be covering these many headlines today, open source development. Why is it important? What is open source software, which is we can also call as a OSS, various open source projects and programs used today. Which are there, you can participate in them, and some quick steps to start your journey. And yes, so I want all of you to continue with the video. Moving to next. So for now, we can start with a simple typical definition, which goes by in open source development, we get an open source software which comes with a code that is designed to be publicly accessible. Anyone can see, modify it, and distribute the code as they see fit. The whole process is known as open source development. So this is all the technical stuff in technical language, which is mostly seen everywhere. To dig in deep, follow up to the next slide. Yes, so what is actually done? What is the whole job behind it? In layman's language, say suppose we take an example of a software company named A. Suppose A, it has its software source code publicly available. Okay, so first we get into what is source code. It is the part of software that most computer users don't ever see. It's the code computer programmers can manipulate to change how a piece of a software, a program or application works. Programmers who have access to the computer program's source code can improve that program by adding features to it or fixing parts that don't always work correctly. Authors of this open source software make its source code available to others who would like to view that code, copy it, learn from it, alter it, or share it. So I hope somewhat picture is getting cleared. Moving forward. So, where do we go next? How do we get there? We will discuss everything in detail. For now, I would request you to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Trust me, our team is working very hard. For your benefit, please show some support. Let's move further. Now the question arises, why OSD? Why open source development? And what is the need of it? So, I would be clearing it out. It encourages innovation through collaboration. As you can see, without it, many of the technologies we take for granted today would never have developed or would be locked away behind some patent law. So, open source is a collaboration model. It guarantees that all of the contributors have certain rights concerning the continued use of the project they are contributing to. Different open source licenses offer different choices. Without it, it would be difficult to get the cooperation of the number and caliber of developers needed for some large projects like the Linux kernel. It would also be difficult to get a small number of contributors to spend the time needed to develop some of the smaller niche packages. So these were the reasons why open source is important. So let's move further. So this is the most important part of our today's session, open source software. These are the software we talked about earlier. The software in which the source code used to create the program is freely available, and it is identified by the type of license it is released under. And the authors of proprietary software, yes, decide if a program is open source or not. In the case of the closed source, a user must be permitted with a proprietary license rights to alter the source code, like Adobe Photoshop or the Google Cloud, for example, do not offer permission for external developers to use or alter that code. It's also important to note that there is a difference between open source software and a free source software. Most of the times you see free source software is also present, don't get confused. Open source software puts far more emphasis on security and licensing. Free source software qualifies as open source, but open source software is not necessarily free. Some programmers do charge money for software or software support. Further, I would request you to gather more information about it and surf the web and get informative. For now, we will move further. So these are some of the biggest open source software available on the web. So you can check out the list, Mozilla Firefox, Linux, Python, Blender, LibreOffice, and the list goes on. These are some of the biggest ones. Once you start your own research, you will get to know more about these. Let's move on. Here I have noted down some of the advantages of open source software. You can pause the video and please read it. So these are the top booming open source technologies. You can learn them as a skill and then practice it and then use open source. So the list goes on as blockchain, containers, mixed reality, cybersecurity, progressive web apps, IoT, Python, big data analytics, cloud computing, machine learning, and the list goes on. These are some of the top ones. You can find your favorite domain, embrace your skills and do open source and contribute in some real world projects and programs. So let's see what's next. So guys, get your eyes to the most famous open source programs, and mostly these are kind of internship programs. We can say fellowship programs, which can give a massive boost to your career. In these kinds of programs, you are assigned to work, say, for a company who participates in it. You get a chance to work with a mentor and complete a project or task given to you by that particular company or organization. In some of these programs, you get a great stipend. These programs last for around 3 to 5 months. As you can see here, one of these programs is Google Summer of Code, also famous by the name GSOC. It's a great opportunity for you if you get into one of these programs. You get to learn a great deal of things and understand the industry level work. Some more programs goes by Outreachy, MLH Fellowship, Google Codein, one more from Google. Let's move forward and learn how to begin your open source journey by working through some simple steps. So let's go. So here are the quick steps in short, which will help you to start your open source journey efficiently. Now, the first and the basic step is to get your hands on some skills before getting started. Ask yourself what project you want to work on. Start with the programming language you know well. What frameworks do you like the best? What problems you have encountered while using them? Once you specify the language you want to work on, you should narrow down a project. GitHub organizes projects into showcases where you can browse for a topic. From there, analyze the volume of that project. If you are new, it's not a great idea to jump into a large software project. Some projects are even labeled as first timers only or easy. So I want you to start from there and move further. So here arises the second step. Get hands-on version control, that is Git. GitHub is the most popular widely used hosting platform for open source projects. If you don't have one already, you need to create an account. You will also need to get familiar with Git. The basic skills you need to learn are cloning a repository, sending pull requests, reviewing changes, discussing changes, and assigning commits. So let's move to the third step. Here goes the third step. Search for your organization. Also, once you find a project you like and learn the basics of Git, join a community that suits you and starts contributing. The easiest way to join is to subscribe to the mailing list of a project. These are usually listed on GitHub pages. You will then be accepted to the team and can start communicating with the members. Now, finally, when you get familiar with the open source environment, you get to solve an issue, you do the necessary changes and contribute. So yes, that's how this works. Let's move further and understand the future scope of open source. For the future scope of open source, I can just say that everybody likes improvement. If it is small business or a massive MNC, everybody want to make their service or product best. So these changes are necessity. So there is no sign of open source technology getting old for the growing world and humanity. You can also read the slide if you wish. For now, open source is a booming field. At the end, open source offers a lot of opportunities, whether you are a novice programmer or an experienced software engineer. Contributing to open source will help further to boost your career and personal development. So, thanks for watching this video, and don't forget to like the video and subscribe to this channel. And do check out our website and follow us on LinkedIn, Instagram, and Facebook. Links for the same will be given down in the description below. Thank you for watching. Stay connected. Goodbye.